Hi guys, in today's video, Lesley, Martin's mum, is going to be talking you through the set notation you'll need when you're solving Venn diagrams.
Okay, so today all we're going to look at are the different symbols that can be used to do with set notation. First of all, the word set itself just means a collection of numbers, a group of colours, anything that's linked together in some way. The different ways of writing down a set can be something like A is the set, and you usually put curly brackets, and you can write it in words, even numbers from 2 to 10, maybe one way of writing it, or you may see a set listed with its actual elements. So the same set would be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. The first bit of notation that you will need is how many elements there are in the set. So in this set, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements. In set notation, this is written as the number of elements in set A is equal to 5. So that tells you how many things there are in the set. The second bit of notation you need is a symbol that stands for is an element of, to indicate that something is a member of a set. The symbol that's used for that is, it's a bit like an E, but it's sort of a C with a line through, a curly E. So for example, I could say 4 is an element of the set 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Because indeed 4 is in that list of numbers, but 5 is not in that list, so you just put a line through. 5 is not an element of the set 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay, once you've used to using the notation for one set, you need to think about what happens when you have two sets combining. So let's stick with the same set A, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. And let's just list another set B, and I'll call the set B multiples of 4. So we'll have 4, 8, 12, 16. Those are just two sets I've made up. There's nothing special about them, just to show you the next bits of notation. Now, there's two bits of notation. First of all, you need a notation for the numbers which are in both sets. And the numbers which are in both sets is the intersection, where they overlap. This is a list of numbers in both sets. The notation is an upside down U, like a bridge, like a tunnel. So if you ever see A intersection B, that just wants you to list the numbers which occur in both sets. So the number 4 is in that set, and the number 4 is in that set. The number 8 is in set A, and the number 8 is in set B. So the intersection of A and B are just the two numbers, 4 and 8. The other notation is you need all the numbers which are everything in A and everything in B. And this is called the union. So this is everything in A and everything in B. But you don't list any number twice. The notation for this is a U for union. So it's quite easy to remember which is which. So A union B is everything in set A. So it's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. And also everything in set B, except when I start listing B, I have already listed the number 4, I have already listed the number 8, so I've only got 12 and 16 to list. So if you look at this A union B, there's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, which are the numbers in set A, and there's also 4, 8, 12, 16, which are the numbers in B. So everything in both A and B are listed there. When it comes to answering the questions, there are one or two other little bits of information you may find useful. For example, this curly E is the symbol that's used for the universal set. that's the set of numbers that the question wants you to consider. So it might be something like, the universal set is the whole set of integers. That's whole numbers. So suppose we are just considering whole numbers. Then they might say, okay, let's define a set A. And the set A is going to be defined as, now rather than putting it words, they're putting it again in symbols. They're saying it's any element X such that the number X lies between 10 and 20. And notice in this notation, it doesn't include the number 10 and it doesn't include the number 20. So if I'm going to list the set A, it's all the numbers between 10 and 20, but not including 10. And it must be a whole number, so I'm not worried about numbers like 11 and a half. I know it has to be integers. So it's 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20 is not included. Same sort of thing again. Let's define the set B. And this time we're saying B is the set of numbers X such that X lies between 5 and 12. And this time we are including the number 5 and we are including the number 12. And again, the universal set is still integers, so we don't have to worry about the fractions and the decimals. So here, the elements of B are 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So if a question wanted me to list the members of A intersection B, intersection, if you remember, is the number that occurs in both sets. So if I look, 11 occurs there and 11 occurs there, 12 occurs in A and 12 occurs in B, and they are the only numbers that occur in set A and in set B. So A intersection B are just the numbers 11 and 12. The other notation, A union B, means everything in A and everything in B. And try and get it into numerical order. So I'm going to start by listing the elements of B first. So it's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Then I'll list these elements in set, the elements in set A. But the 11 and the 12 I've already written down here. So the rest of the elements are 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. If a question then asked you for the number of elements in set A, you just go back to set A and count how many there are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So the number of elements in set A is 9. The number of elements in set B, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And there's 8 elements in set A. One last bit of notation for this section. You can have a set with no elements in at all, and this is called the empty or the null set. This might seem a strange idea, but if I define my set A to be quadrilaterals, which are shapes with 4 sides, and my set B to be triangles, which are shaped with 3 sides, and I am asked to list the elements of A intersection B. Well, fairly clearly, there's nothing. No shape can have 4 sides and 3 sides at the same time. So there's nothing in that set. And we write this either as curly brackets with nothing inside or a circle with a line through. They both mean this set has nothing in it. Don't write a 0 inside the curly brackets, because that would mean a 0 was actually in the set A intersection B, which it isn't. It's just 2 curly brackets with nothing inside them.